MedCram.com.
Okay, well, welcome to another MedCram lecture presented at MedCram.com. Please join us over there at MedCram.com, where we've got great videos and reviews. We're going to talk about, again, eosinophilic pneumonia, and we're going to round out this lecture with the top four that I think you ought to know. And let's get started. First of all, let's name what they are, the primary eosinophilic pneumonias. And I'm going to divide them into two categories. We're going to talk about the lung and systemic. So there is one in the lungs. There are those systemic. So actually two in the lungs and two of them that are systemic. The first one is acute eosinophilic pneumonia. Then we have chronic eosinophilic pneumonia. And then here we have the hyper eosinophilic syndrome, I should say, not pneumonia. And finally, the what we call EGPA, which you should know stands for the eosinophilic granulomatosis with polyangiitis, otherwise known as CHURG, that's Churg-Strauss, STRAUSS. So these are our four diseases. Now, in terms of the diagnoses and the similarities, they're going to ask you about these four diseases, and they are different in some ways. First of all, let's talk about where the eosinophils are found. Now, as I mentioned, usually they're found in both the lungs and the blood, and that's the case here. So here I'm going to write both to show that it's both in the blood and also in the lungs. Here it's eosinophilia is found both in the lung and the blood, and here as well, both in the lungs and the blood. Whereas here it's just found in the lungs. So no blood. The way to think about that is an acute eosinophilic pneumonia, it's starting in the lungs, it doesn't have time to make it into the blood. That might be a way to think about it. The next thing we want to look at is the gender predilection. So whereas this is the unique one in terms of where the eosinophilia is found, this one here is the unique one in terms of the fact that it's typically found in females, whereas every other one is typically male predominant. Okay, now in terms of markers, you should know that this one is unique in that the major marker is P. ANCA, and all the other ones have IL-5 mediation, which makes sense because that's the major issue with eosinophilia. The other thing that's, of course, interesting is that you're going to get vasculitis and monoplex neuropathy. So neuropathy and vasculitis. Now the theory is that when people are put on leukotriene receptor antagonists, that you're able to, as a result, reduce the steroids that you have to use in people with asthma. And as a result of that, when you reduce the steroids, it tends to cause this Churg-Strauss disease to come out. Now, this has led some people to believe that that there actually is a connection between LTRAs and this disease, but that is hotly debated. With EGPA, or Churg-Strauss syndrome, the biggest issue is morbidity and mortality from the heart, or CARDS. It is typically seen in asthma, so we'll put that in a different color here for you. Asthma is big. Here, of course, in chronic eosinophilic pneumonia, asthma is also big. The other interesting thing here is that it's predominantly in women, but also on the x-ray, it has the photographic negative of pulmonary edema. What do I mean by that? If you were to look on the x-ray, whereas in pulmonary edema, typically it's starting from the middle, which is where the vascularity is, here it's towards the edge. Okay? Now, the treatments for all of these, no surprise, is steroids. Steroids for acute eosinophilic pneumonia, and usually there is no relapse. For chronic eosinophilic pneumonia, you guessed it, steroids, and they can get better within hours to days, but there may be a relapse. So they need a longer course, perhaps even months, typically months, to make sure that the chronic eosinophilic pneumonia doesn't come back. For hypereosinophilic syndrome, the treatment is steroids as well. But in this case, because of the IL-5, you may use an IL-5 inhibitor, which, as you may recall, is mepolizumab. Okay? And then the treatment here in Churg-Strauss is steroids. But you can also do more rigorous steroids, for instance, like methotrexate and azathioprine. The other thing that you might see as well is elevated IgE levels. Okay, so what are the things that I think are going to be important to understand for this? You've got to know for eosinophilic pneumonias that, number one, acute eosinophilic pneumonia is only in the lungs. So the only way you're going to make the diagnosis is if you do a BAL, that's a bronchoalveolar lavage, or a bronchoscopy. All the other ones are both in the lungs and in the serum. In terms of women, this is the one they're going to get most often, the chronic. The other thing you ought to know is the photographic negative of pulmonary edema. That's very important. These two are both very responsive to steroids. The acute does not relapse. And you can think of it that it doesn't relapse because it's only in the lungs, and it's only in the lungs because it hasn't had a chance to spread to the blood, and that's because it's acute. For hypereosinophilic syndrome, you're going to see multiple parts of the body, multiple organs involved. You can, because it's IL-5 mediated specifically here, you can use mepolizumab, which is an autoantibody against IL-5, but the treatment is steroids. And typically, to get this diagnosis, you need to have this for at least 6 months. So this is not an easy diagnosis. Sometimes over here, they have asthma for up to 10 years. So just so you're aware of that. So Churg-Strauss, remember that medications like leukotriene receptor antagonists like montelukast can unmask it. It's typically seen both in the blood and also in the lungs. Typically male, this P. anca is going to give you vasculitis. That is going to give you purpura, could give you nodules, petechiae. You could even get diffuse alveolar hemorrhage, very rarely, it's not common. You're going to get neuropathy, and you're going to get morbidity and mortality from cardiology issues. Remember, steroids, azathioprine, and methotrexate. Okay, so big picture, know the difference between acute and chronic, and then know both or lungs. Thanks for joining us.